Welcome back to Long Beach Treasures. Now from the band shell to the dog beach, we're right back, and joining me is Justin Rudd, who was, he's a community activist and advocate, and you were a mover and shaker in getting this beach started, weren't you?
Yes. Several years ago, I had the idea that I wanted to take my bulldog Rosie to the beach, and I knew that I couldn't because it was against the law. So what I did was I found in the Long Beach City Code a clause that said that dogs could be allowed on the beach for a special event. So what I did is I went to the special events office and filed for a permit to have a special event where we could have two or three acres here in Belmont Shore where dogs could be off leash on a particular Sunday afternoon. And what we ended up doing is having it down at Cherry, by Cherry Avenue, the first afternoon, and we did it there for 4 hours. We had about 500 dogs show up, and for over consecutive months I would have these same special events that would allow dogs to be off leash for a summer. We did it for 21 consecutive months, and then after that we said to the city we wanted to put together a pilot program that we could demonstrate that it could work here in Belmont Shore, and it did. And today we have 3 acres of off-leash area where the dogs can come and have some fun in the water and here on the sand.
Did you find a lot of opposition when you first proposed this?
I think there are people who are leery when you're trying anything new for the first time. People were concerned about dog poop being left behind or dog bites or dogs crossing the bike path. But I think once you prove it to them, and that's why we did the special events, that's why we did the pilot program, that it can happen and that it does work and that it's highly popular. This dog beach, during the summer months when it's warm outside on a weekend, they're going to have about 100 dogs at a time here on the dog beach. So that's thousands of, or maybe 2,000 dogs that will come in and out on any one Saturday or Sunday. So it's obviously very popular. It's the most popular place here on the entire 4 miles of Pacific coastline.
You know, this is so much nicer than the dog park up there in Recreation Park, because at least it's cleaner here, and I don't know, it's more open and free.
I think the dog park at Recreation Dog Park on 7th serves a purpose, you know, for people that want to go in a place where it's fenced in, and it is fortunately another place that dogs can be off leash in the city. But this dog beach here is the only dog beach in all of Los Angeles County. So with the, I don't know, 10 or 11 million people that live in Los Angeles County, this is the only place at the beach where they can legally come to. It is not fenced in. It's simply orange cones that surround the perimeter of the dog beach here. So the dogs, dogs are pack animals. They like to stay together and play together, run around, chase balls, chase frisbees.
What are the restrictions?
Well, it's pretty simple. No aggressive dogs. You can have one dog per adult. Here at the dog beach, there's no human food or pet food allowed in the dog beach. They're not allowed. The dogs must be have a collar and a tag from the Long Beach Animal Control or from wherever they're coming from. So if they're coming from Los Angeles, they have to have a tag from LA Animal Control.
Is it open 24/7?
The dog beach is open 6 a.m. to 8 p.m., so almost 24/7. Almost, it's daylight hours, basically. And it's right here between Argonne and Roycroft Avenues. It's in Belmont Shore. It is 3 acres.
Now, have they had many problems here at the dog beach?
I think as with any off-leash area or with any dogs you put together, there's going to be dog fights that happen from time to time. And yes, there have been some dog fights here. And I think it would be smart for someone to come here and be aware that that's going to happen anytime you have dogs together. But as a general rule, it's a fun place to come to bring your dogs off-leash, whether it's a little dog or a big dog. There's all breeds, all sizes, and they're all having a good time here in Long Beach.
It's fun to watch them run in the water and chase each other, and it's just so free and open down here.
And you've got to remember that there are a lot of dogs that come here for the very first time they're coming to the beach, and it's a new experience for them, new sights, new smells, new texture in the sand, and then getting in the water. And it's to watch them run around in circles and play like that, that makes me smile, and I see the smiles on these dogs' faces when they're doing it.
The German Shepherd is my dog, and when we first came down here, she wouldn't go in the water, but now she loves the water.
I think a lot of dogs, or many dogs, can be leery to come into the water because they're hearing the loud sounds. A dog's ears are very sensitive to sound, and obviously a dog's nose is very sensitive to smell. And so it's a lot of stimulus are in this at one time. They get used to it. And the thing is, you know, with shepherds or with retrievers, they go right in there and chasing after those balls.
You know, because of the success of this park, have there been any other dog beaches that have been opened up within the area?
No, not recently. Los Angeles has tried, the South Bay has tried to put a dog beach in the flight path at Dockweiler Beach. Pacific Palisades has tried to put a dog beach there. Santa Monica has tried, and they've tried for years and years, and it just has not worked. What was fortunate for us is that we're dealing mostly with the city of Long Beach, because this is a city-run beach. It's run by the Long Beach Parks, Recreation, and Marine. And so we don't have to go through county government like those other beaches do.
Well, being an advocate, you're just going to have to go up to these areas and show them how it's done.
Well, I guess so. And I think it also helps that, you know, for me being a dog advocate here in Long Beach, you know, with the Hot Dog Easter Parade, the Hot Dog Halloween Parade, the Bulldog Beauty Contest, it helps that there was somebody pushing the cause along that was a familiar face and people knew who I was and what I was doing. You know, I also happened to organize the dog or the beach cleanup that happens down here on the third Saturday every month. And I've been doing that well before the dog beach was ever here. And so I think that track record also speaks highly for us.
How many do you get on the beach cleanup usually?
We just did a beach cleanup this past weekend. We had right at 300 volunteers. So anywhere two to 300 volunteers show up.
That's quite a few.
Yeah, it's every third Saturday of each month, rain or shine. We have bags, gloves, refreshments, door prizes. Free parking.
Just down here in Belmont Shore?
We always be in Belmont Shore. It's right next to the dog beach. We meet at the end of Granada Avenue. So the address is 1 Granada Avenue. And we have all ages that come down to the beach cleanup. I mean, from little kids to older adults. We had a woman celebrating her 89th birthday at the beach cleanup this past Saturday. Yeah.
That's tremendous. How do you come up with all of these things?
You know, these are all things that I enjoy doing. I think that there are needs for them in the community. Like just this last weekend, we did the mom prom. We do the father-daughter dance. I happen to do 38 events a year, but they're all events that I would love to go to or love to be involved with that weren't happening. And I just said to myself, I want this to happen. I'm making it happen. I choose to do it. I made it happen.
Now, are these profit or nonprofit events?
All of this is run through my nonprofit organization called the Community Action Team. They can check out my website, justinrudd.com, for all the details.
Well, Justin, I want to thank you for joining me, and I want to thank you for initiating this dog beach, because it's a tremendous success, and you know, they just really enjoy it, and I'm so pleased that you had the fortitude to do it, and I'm glad the city council approved, and I want to thank you for joining me.
You're welcome.
That's our show for this time. Be sure and come back next time as we take another walk through history and uncover more Long Beach treasures.